And he said, well, you're still a fool. He said, just work at it then until you go. He said, no, no. He said, it's not God's will. And thanks for the offer, and I appreciate it. And it was just a few days later, maybe 2 or 3 weeks later, that they phoned us. We'd been trying so hard to get on a boat. It was all it was then. And we couldn't find a place on a boat for a family of seven. And just a few days later, we got that phone call. Can you leave for Africa in 6 days? And I'm so grateful today. I'm so grateful. But you see, every day of our life, every day of our life, there's a statement that I've got to make now. I want to make it for this many folks that are here. It's very important. We were made our last trip to Africa in that position. Well, already retired. I guess another last trip to Africa we made from January through April, most of April. And I got letters and we got phone calls, and we know this trip is awful hard on you folks. And then the letters begin to come in. I know you're going to miss Africa, and I know you're going to be grieving. Hey, folks, you don't understand the will of God. When God shows me his will, I ain't grieving over nothing. Chapter should, with Jesus leading as we knew he would. That's all I can remember of it.